That much.
Not as much as spending the rest of my life in this wheelchair.
And that's why you're here, right? To fight for the right to make your own decision.
Yes. Look, if there was no chance I'd ever walk again, obviously we wouldn't be here. I would just have to deal with being in a wheelchair. I mean, people do it all the time. People have jobs, families, people play sports. But I have a chance to walk again. My grandpa always said that I was a Buchanan, and that Buchanans take chances, and that's the way we live. My parents said the same thing. But now, it's like they didn't mean any of it. Look, I'm 15. I'm not 6. I'm old enough to know that this is a serious operation, and that I might not make it through. But I'm willing to take that chance. And if I don't, I'll spend the rest of my life wondering what could have happened. And the only walking I'll do is in my dreams.
No further questions, Your Honor.
Let's take a brief recess.
You really love to take chances, don't you? Hinting around about people like Beau and Nora and Clint.
I really don't have time to chat. I need to look at my notes.
You were awesome up there. I'd operate on you myself if I could.
I think we better leave that up to your brother.
And after today, maybe we will. I'll be right over there.
Matthew?
Dad?
What you said just now, that was tough to hear.
It's the truth.
All rise.
Be seated. Young man, just to remind you, you're still under oath.
Thank you.
Your witness, Mr. Clark.
Matthew, enlighten us. Why do you think you have the maturity to make a decision of this magnitude about your health? Wasn't it your own bad judgment that put you in this wheelchair in the first place?
Objection, Your Honor. That assumes facts, not in evidence. That would be irrelevant.
This 15-year-old boy is petitioning for the right to make a critical medical decision. His judgment, or lack thereof, is at the very center of this case.
Establish a foundation.
Thank you, Your Honor. Matthew, the night of the accident, after you left the dance, exactly what did you do?
I got a ride from my friend, Cole Thornhart. We got into an accident and I was thrown from the car.
Well, how could that have happened if you were wearing your seatbelt? Matthew, was your seatbelt defective?
No.
Did it break in the crash?
No.
I mean, your mom and dad taught you to buckle up, didn't they? You do know it's the law, don't you?
Yes.
So then, how were you thrown from the car?
I wasn't wearing my seatbelt.
Your Honor, this is harassment. Matthew is in no way responsible for the accident that paralyzed him.
Again, this speaks to his judgment and maturity.
I'll allow it.
Matthew, why weren't you wearing your seatbelt?
I wasn't thinking.
Why not?
There was this thing at the dance.
A thing?
I don't know. Like a joke. These kids were making fun of me. I had to get out of there fast.
So you ran out of that dance, jumped in the first car you saw, and then just didn't buckle your seatbelt?
No, it didn't happen like that.
Would you call that sound judgment? Would you say it was a mature decision?
Matthew's not the one who made the big mistake here. It's his parents. The people who put Matthew in that wheelchair are Becca and her boy Justin. They did the meanest thing I've ever seen on school grounds, and they never paid 1 minute for it.
You have been warned, miss.
Sit down, Destiny. This isn't helping.
All right, Matthew. Matthew. So you were upset about Becca and her boy, Justin, and you forgot to buckle up.
Yeah.
But that wasn't the worst of it. You knew Cole Thornhart was using drugs, didn't you?
Kind of.
A fact you never bothered to share with your parents, right?
I didn't know how bad it is.
You know what grown-ups do when they think someone has a drug problem?
I guess it depends.
They get that person help.
Your Honor, he's testifying.
I'm allowing this line of inquiry. But ask questions.
Again, thank you, Your Honor. Matthew, did you know Cole was high that night?
Not at first.
Did he say anything that might have given you a clue?
No, he just wanted me to get out of the car.
Okay, so let me get this straight. The drug user that you'd chosen to drive you home tried to get you out of the car, but yet you insisted on riding anyway.
Look, I just wanted to get home.
You'd have done anything to get out of that dance, huh? Just like you'd do anything to walk again. What do you think that says about your judgment?
Okay, I'm sorry. I made a mistake. Everyone makes mistakes. Why don't you ask my parents? About you, they did something that they regret.
We're talking about your judgment, Matthew. Once you realized or even suspected that Cole was in an altered state, you didn't try to get out of the car. You didn't ask him to pull over and let you out.
No, I just...
You didn't even put on your seatbelt when you knew he was high.
No, I made a bad mistake.
Actually, you made several that night, Matthew. You could have stopped this chain of events at any point.
Objection.
But every time, you made a bad choice that in the end put you in this wheelchair. Now, the next decision you make could put you in the ground.
Objection, Your Honor. That is outrageous.
No further questions.
Redirect. So, Matthew, you know you made some mistakes on the night of the accident, correct?
Yes.
You made some impulsive decisions that, as you have already explained to us, you know cost you dearly.
Yes.
Okay. How has that changed you?
I don't do anything without thinking now. I can't.
Mm-hmm. You really consider your decisions carefully now.
Especially big ones.
Mm-hmm. And have you really considered the decision about whether or not to get surgery?
Yes. I went online. I researched it. I talked to Dr. Evans. I read what doctors said about Dr. Evans. I read patient reviews from people who had the same surgery that I want to get from Dr. Evans.
Mm-hmm. So you spent a lot of time on this.
It's all I've thought about ever since I heard there was a surgery that could help me walk again.
Mm-hmm. You've looked at it from many different angles.
Yes.
No further questions, Your Honor.
We're adjourned until tomorrow.
All rise.
I thought we had an understanding.
We do. You want to win.
No, you can't go tearing Matthew to pieces like that.
Laura, what would you rather see? A little discomfort on the witness stand or your son in a coffin?
No, don't do that to her.
I want my son whole. But I want him happy, too.
It's just too bad he doesn't feel the same way about you. You heard the swipe he took at you guys about your big secret lapse in judgment?
We heard.
So clearly he and Tay aren't above playing dirty.
Hey, Matthew. Listen. You did great. On redirect, you were wonderful. The judge will definitely see the differences between that night and now.
He's definitely getting that surgery, isn't he?
I have every reason to hope.
Thanks, the two of you.
Sure.
See you later. We're ready to go, are you?
Yeah, I'll meet you at the car.
All right.
You guys fight it out in there. And then you guys get in the same car and go home together?
Yeah, I know, right? It's been fun so far, but I'm glad I have a big house. I can't wait to get home.
Matthew, wait just a minute. I think we need to talk about what you said in court today.
Which part?
What you said about your mom and me.
Well, I didn't tell them about you and Mom making out before our wedding.
It wasn't making out...
Look, if you plan on using this against us in court, I'd like a chance to talk to Uncle Clint first. I know right now you probably hate your mom and me, but I know that you care about him. I don't think he deserves to be blindsided. Don't you think?
A lot of